Shalom, Rastafari. I am Alon Kone Tafari, and today is May 2nd, 2012, and I've been working on a children's book. And coincidentally enough, it'll be out just before May 5th, which is by the teachings of Our Imperial Majesty Haile Selassie, a day to keep in remembrance for all those who sacrificed their lives so that I and I can speak today for the acts that they committed yesterday. Now, I'd like to read a short passage. May 5th, 1941, Ethiopia Liberation Day. People of my country, Ethiopia, today is a day on which Ethiopia is stretching her hands to God in joy and thankfulness and revealing her happiness to her children. This day on which the people of Ethiopia are free from oppressive foreign yoke and eternal servitude, and on which I am enabled to rejoin my people whom I love and have longed for, will be honored as a holiday to be commemorated annually as a great Ethiopian anniversary. Yes, by reading this passage, I hope that I and I are blessed with a most wonderful May 5th. Now, continuing on, I'd like to note that this book is not the final draft, it's actually a rough draft. The text, which is included, which I will present just to share on the images, is not in fact the text that will be included in the book. Now, it just came off the top of my head, to be sincere. Now, I was, while working on this project, it came to me that it would be most magnificent if this, in fact, became a collective work or collective project. So I'd like to ask for the cooperation of any willing Rastafari to assist I and I with the actual text. Now, the visuals have been completed, but if any of the Idrian, Sistrian brethren have any ideas on what kind of material would the eyes like included in the actual book, then I would be more than happy to take advice and actually do what I and I as a whole, as the body of Jesus Christus, Yehoshua HaMashiach, would like to incorporate in this book, being that the storyline is not just mine, rather we all form the body. And so that being said, I'm looking for structure on the text. It's a children's book, should we make it a story, just a children's story? Should it be just a bunch of facts? What kind of facts should I and I include? What would the sistren and brethren like included? Those are the kind of the details that I and I can assist Iman with. And so think about it. If anybody have any ideas, I'm gonna post my email address at the end of the vid, so I'll be in contact. If any willing Rastafari, let I know, and we'll make this we'll figure out what to do with the text. So Shalom, Rastafari, thank you. Give thanks to the Most High, and I hope you enjoy. Whatever the task may be, man may begin it, but he cannot complete it unless Jah sustains and supports him. Haile Selassie I. Table of Commandment. And God spoke all these words, saying, I am the Lord thy God, which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage. Thou shalt have no other gods before me. Thou shalt not make to thee any graven image, or any likeness of anything that is in heaven above, or that is in the earth beneath, or that is in the water under the earth. Thou shalt not bow down thyself to them, nor serve them. For I, the Lord thy God, am a jealous God, visiting the iniquity of the father upon the children to the third and fourth generation of them that hate me, and showing mercy to thousands of them that love me, and keep my commandments. Thou shalt not take the name of thy Lord, thy God, in vain. Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. 6 days shalt thou labor and do all thy work, but the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Lord, thy God. In it thou shalt not do any work, thou, nor thy son, nor thy daughter, nor thy manservant, nor thy maidservant, nor thy cattle, nor thy stranger that is within thy gates. For in 6 days the Lord made heaven and earth, the sea, and all that in them is, and rested the seventh day. Wherefore the Lord blessed the Sabbath day and hallowed it. Honor thy father and mother, that thy days may be long upon the land which the Lord thy God giveth thee. Thou shalt not kill. Thou shalt not commit adultery. Thou shalt not steal. Thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's house. Thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's wife, nor his manservant, nor his maidservant, nor his ox, nor his ass, nor anything that is thy neighbor's. Solomon and Sheba. In the days of old, to the south, there ruled over the land known as Sheba the beautiful Queen Makeda of Ethiopia, full of wisdom, enough even to leave all in search of more. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord. Motivated by these words, Queen Makeda of Ethiopia journeyed in hope of finding the man who spoke them. The journey led Queen Makeda to Jerusalem, where she was to meet this man, who was known to be the most wise of all. The all-wise King Solomon of Jerusalem, in all his glory, had not seen such beauty as that of Queen Makeda, and neither King Solomon nor Queen Makeda, in all their splendor, could have imagined what was to result of this meeting. Page 1. A child is born in Ethiopia. The Almighty God Jah, having the ultimate wisdom, far exceeding that of man, knew that his seed, once holy in Jerusalem, having grown among thorns, was short of breath. Soon his seed was to be as chaff that the wind blew it away. For this reason, Jah blessed the union of King Solomon and Queen Makeda with a child. When Queen Makeda of Ethiopia went back to her land and people, she brought with her the promise that Jah had made to our fathers. Queen Makeda gave birth to the son of Solomon, which was the son of David. His name was Menelik the First. When Menelik was older, he visited his father Solomon. Upon his return from Jerusalem, Menelik brought with him the Ark of the Covenant, and was established in Ethiopia as the first king of the newly established Solomonic dynasty. As time passed, the seed of Jah was carefully preserved in the mountains of Ethiopia, and in 1892 a root of David was sprung out of her, and a child was born, Lij Tafari. The Son of Man was born in her. Set upon the throne of David. The child Lij Tafari, at age 13, was presented with the title Dejasmach in the region of Gaba Mulata. The highly respected child was now a young boy, taking on responsibility and coming to the age of manhood. Later was appointed the title Ras and given the governorship of Harar province as Ras Tafari. Ras Tafari was to be Negus, King Tafari, in the year of 1928. And by the will of the Almighty Jah, creator of all that is good, being the brightness of his glory and the express image of his person, upholding all things by the word of his power, was made to sit upon the throne of David as the majesty on high, to again be a father to him that had been made so much better than the angels. On November 2, 1930, Rastafari was crowned emperor of Ethiopia. Receiving the holy anointing, Rastafari took on himself His Imperial Majesty, Kidamawi Haile Selassie, King of Kings, Elect of God, Conquering Lion of the Tribe of Judah, Emperor of Ethiopia. The dragon makes war with the saints. Roman Vatican Empire allies with Italy. Benito Mussolini, Victor Emmanuel, and fascist Italy along with the Vatican and blessings from the Pope set out on what they called civilizing mission to invade Ethiopia for no reason other than envy, jealousy, and a grudge stemming from Italy's humiliating defeat by Ethiopian warriors during the Battle of Adwa. Since the turn of the century, Rome had been preparing for their second attempt to erase from history true Christianity, the true identity of the House of Israel, and stop the rise of the Ethiopian Christ reality. The Emperor Haile Selassie, along with his faithful warriors, fought fiercely, but because of the unbalance of military might, the country advised the Emperor to plead before the leaders of the world on Ethiopia's behalf. Appeal to the League of Nations. It is collective security. It is the very existence of the League of Nations. It is the confidence that each state is to place in international treaties. It is the value of promises made to small states that their integrity and their independence shall be respected and ensured. It is the principle of the equality of states on the one hand, or otherwise the obligation laid upon small powers to accept the bonds of vassalship. In a word, it is international morality that is at stake. Have the signatures appended to a treaty value only in so far as the signatory powers have a personal, direct, and immediate interest involved? No subtlety can change the problem or shift the grounds on the discussion. It is in all sincerity that I submit these considerations to the Assembly. At the time when my people are threatened with extermination, when the support of the League may ward off the final blow, may I be allowed to speak with complete frankness, without resistance, in all directness, such as is demanded by the rule of equality as between all state members of the League. Apart from the kingdom of Jah Rastafari, there is not on this earth any nation that is superior to another. Should it happen that a strong government finds it may with impunity destroy a weak people, then the hour strikes for that weak people to appeal to the League of Nations to give its judgment in all freedom. God and history will remember your judgment. Enemies thine footstool. What I would finally announce to you, my people, is that today is a day of rejoicing for us all. Today is a day on which we defeated our enemy. Therefore, when we say, let us all rejoice with our hearts, let not our rejoicing be in any other way but in the Spirit of Christ. Do not return evil for evil. Do not indulge in the atrocities which the enemy has been practicing in his usual way, even up to the last moment. Take care not to spoil the good name of Ethiopia by acts which are worthy of the enemy. We shall see that our enemies are disarmed and sent the way they came. As Saint George, who killed the dragon, is the patron saint of our army as well as of our allies, let us unite with our allies in everlasting friendship and amity in order to be able to stand against the godless and cruel dragon which has newly risen and which is oppressing mankind. I charge you to consider them as a brother and a friend and to show them kindness and consideration. True and faithful witness. And I wept much, because no man was found worthy to open and to read the book, neither to look thereon. And one of the elders said to me, weep not, behold, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, The root of David hath prevailed to open the book and to loose the seven seals thereof. Abatachinhoi besemayemetenor semech yekedes mengeshtech timta pekadech besemay endehonich indihu bemidet tehun yeilet enjirachinenen seten zare bedelachinenem yeker belen enya enya ye bedelunenen yeker endemenel wede betenam atagiban Kekifu adinen engi mengesht yantenatina chaylam misganam lezele alemu. Amen. Israel hoy sima amlakachin igisi abher ande igisi abher newa.